each other.
No, I love you, baby. We need to tie the knot real soon, baby.
How about right now?
Oh my God, are you serious? Oh.
Will you marry me?
No, I will, baby. Oh, God. Come here, you big furry man, you.
Matrimony is a sacred bond, or covenant, between a man and a woman that pledges them to be faithful, lifelong spouses, loving and caring for each other, and lovingly raising and guiding the children they bring into the world. Kinda like me and Wesley, we're just so in love with each other. Oh, I love them to pieces. Through the sacrament, the couple are given the grace they need to be true to their pledge. The following abbreviated version, The Gift of the Magi, a classic short story by 1900 era writer O. Henry, offers the tender portrait of a marriage relationship. As a sacrament, matrimony is an encounter with God. Specifically, it celebrates a couple's commitment to share the whole of their life together and to reveal God's love to themselves, their children, and others through their marriage relationship. Stella and Jim's story warmly portrays the essence of the meaning of marriage. Through marriage, we explore four concepts that underscore the rich sacramental quality of the marriage. Mutual self-giving, faithfulness, the becoming of one's real soul, and creativity. Wherever there is human love and friendship, God is revealed, and I can see God within Wesley, and it's pretty hot. And the first letter of John expresses this reality with a beautiful simplicity. God is love, and those who abide in love, kinda like the dude in God, and God abides in them, kinda like the dude. Because of the unique aspects of the friendship that is the marriage relationship, matrimony has always had a special place in the Judeo-Christian vision as a way of revealing God's love in human terms. Of all human relationships, the marriage relationship represents in the most vivid way how God relates to us. In a real sense, a husband and wife reveal God to themselves and those around. I just can't wait to marry this big furry man named Wesley.
When people decide to marry, like me and my wife Kevin, they're making a choice that will affect not just them, but the whole community, that's their relatives, their friends, and especially the church. To marry in the church does not necessarily mean to marry in a church itself. It means to make promises to each other with this, that they will support and present their faith in the community. The community is there to celebrate with them and witness this beautiful thing that me and Kevin will be undertaking. The community itself is one of the very big symbols in matrimony. The priest or deacon at a wedding of a Catholic is a witness of the marriage who receives mutual consent of the couple in the name of the whole church and gives them the blessing of the church, which is very important to me and Kevin because we're very active in the church.
Matrimony is an encounter with God, and it's a symbol of a couple's commitment to each other. Like Kevin and Wes, they're going to show their commitment through their relationship with marriage. God is present in the sacrament of marriage and after. And they're going to share that with their friends, their kids, and everybody who's at that reception, and everybody that's a part of their relationship.
Marriage is a contract, and traditionally, it has been thought of in contractual terms. That is, marriage is thought of as holding the man and woman certain obligations and conferring on them certain rights.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to join these two in holy matrimony. Do you have a ring?
Yes, I do.
Do you take her to be your lovely husband's wife?
I do.
Do you take him to be your husband?
I do.
Extreme drink. I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss.
sexual intercourse is intended only for marriage because it embodies the total sharing of a whole committed life together. In the words of the Catholic Church document, marriage is the communion of the whole life. A loving sexual relationship can joyfully and pleasurably express a communion.
Faithfulness is a very big part of matrimony, and I intend on staying faithful to my wife, Kevin, 110%. Wow, what a marvelous hotel.
You can say that again, Hello,
sir. May I take your coat?
Yes, you can.
Let me show you to your room. Right this way. Nicest room in the hotel.
Enjoy it. Thank you.
Try not to make it too unbearable for people next door.
Alright, we will try our hardest, sir. Stay was fabulous.
I loved it. I loved the whole place.
I love you.
The whole atmosphere of the place.
Since biblical times, man has witnessed and recorded strange manifestations in the sky and speculated on the possibilities of